Morning class, welcome to the online class. We are doing chapter number one, topographical maps, and today we are going to study scale. We are going to study the topic called scale. Now, as you know, every map is provided with some aid or tool like title, not line, symbols, okay, legend, as well as grid reference to help us read that particular map. If you look through your atlas or any map, you will see maps of countries, continents, their physical features, as well as even of the whole world. And if you look at the picture, you'll find that picture is reduced in size than the actual size of that particular picture, where very large areas of the earth are basically shown on a small sheet of paper. So the big picture of the earth is basically shown on a small sheet of paper. Do you know how this is done? It is done with the help of scale. By making a small distance on paper, which represents a larger distance on the ground. So, it is done by making not only the small distance, but also the small picture, small size, as well as, okay, the scale is also very, very small, which represents a larger distance on the ground. This ground is known as the actual, okay, distance of the earth, or it is also called the earth, or actual distance. It is decided that a particular length on paper will show a particular distance on the ground. So it is decided that a particular length, okay, I'm writing only PARTI, okay, particular length, okay, will show a particular distance on ground. So what particular length will be shown on a paper? This paper is called the map. So what particular distance or length will be shown on the paper? That particular distance will be shown on the ground. So we are talking about distance on the map is equal to distance on the ground. The aim of every map is to diagrammatically to show an area of the earth in a small size or in a miniature form. All maps are therefore drawn on the scale to give at least the truest, okay, picture of the earth, a representation of the earth. For example, let's take for example in the scale only. For example, okay, distance means what? What does distance mean? Distance is the space. Is the space. SPACE, space. Between how many points? Between 2 points. Isn't that correct or not? Distance means from A to B. Okay, sorry. This is known as distance. Between the 2 points is the space. Is the space? Space is here between 2 points, A and B. So this is the point one, this is the point two. Between the 2 points. It may be short, it may be long. It depends upon the particular, okay, distance of a particular area. In India, we use the metric system. So to measure the distance, okay, we use the metric system. So to measure distance is measured. So I'm writing measuring distance, or the distance is measured, okay, by METRIC, metric system. This system is known as what? Now, a lot of people knows about it. It is known as kilometers, okay? It is known as kilometers, M-E-T-E-R as meters, okay? Meters, M-E-T-R-E as meters, okay? And centimeters, C-E-N-T-I, centi, M-E-T-E-meters, okay? So, distance is measured by a metric system. This metric system is known as centimeters, meters, and kilometers. Okay? It can also be in millimeters. It can also be in decimeters. It can also be in miles, okay? Then foot, etc. Okay? Are you understanding? So, there are 1,000 meters in, okay, 1 kilometer. There are 1,000 meters in 1 kilometer. And 100 centimeters in 1 meter. So I'm writing on the blackboard with a box here. You can, okay, copy this one in your rough copy, okay? 1 kilometer is equal to how many meters? 1,000 meters, yeah? Then 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So 1,000 meter is known as 1 kilometer. So 1 kilometer is 1,000 meter. So 1,000 meter is known as 1 kilometer. So how much is 1 kilometer? It is 1 lakh centimeter. 1 lakh centimeter. So how much is 1,000 meter? It is 1 lakh centimeter. How much is 1 kilometer? It is 1 lakh centimeter. Remember that. Now the distance. If you are talking about distance, which is measured by the metric system, okay. And distance is the space between the two points. The distance is always measured in a straight line. We can measure it with the help of a ruler. I have a stick here. I don't have a ruler right now, okay? So let's take for example. From A to B, okay? This is the point one, okay, point one. Point two. So how you are going to measure it? With the help of a ruler. With the help of a ruler, you are going to measure it. In the ruler, okay, your units of measurement are in which, okay, metric system? They are in centimeters. Are you getting my point? So, with the help of a ruler, you can measure the distance with distance by using the metric system that is known as centimeters. So the distance is normally measured in a straight line. On the map, the distance is measured with the help of a scale. So now on the blackboard, I am using a scale. So let's take for example, this stick is a scale. With the help of the scale, I am measuring the distance from A to B. On the map also, we have a scale. And we can measure the distance with the help of the scale, which is written at the bottom of the map. So at the bottom of the map, you always have a scale. Now I want to show you the scale, okay? Let's take for example, a topographical map only. Now, this is a topographical map that I showed you last time only. This is known as 45D7, etc. Okay, now if you look here, at the bottom of this topographical map, you have a scale. This is shown in a fraction or ratio. This is known as representative fraction, which we are going to study, okay? Which we are studying, okay? So, this is a scale. This scale is used to measure the distance from one point to another point with the help of a ruler or a twine, that is a string or a divider, etc., okay? So, we use the scale for measuring the distance from one point to another with the help of a ruler or a twine, that is a string or a divider, okay? Now, let us consider two places, point A and point B. Now, I have written here point A. Point A is already written on the blackboard, so I'm writing point A. And point B, this is point B, which are 100 kilometers apart. From A to B, it is 100 kilometers apart. They are 100 kilometers apart. If we say that 1 centimeter on the map stands for 50 kilometers on the ground. Let's take for example, I will make a scale here. Okay? A simple scale, okay? I will make here. Okay? Now it starts from 0, 1. Okay? Then 2. Then 3. I'm writing here. Okay? So I will write this centimeters at the top. So that it doesn't get confused. Okay, so 1 kilometer, okay, 1 centimeter means 50 kilometers. So how much is 2 centimeter? This is in centimeters. This is in centimeters. This is in centimeters. So this is 100 kilometer. This is 150 kilometer. Okay. Now if you look at this scale, if you look at this scale, this is presented in centimeters. The upper part is presented in centimeters. This is presented in kilometers. Now from point A to B, if we say the distance, okay, between from point A to point B is 100 kilometers apart. If we say that 1 centimeter on the map stands for 50 kilometers on the ground. So let's check for example. From point A to B, actual distance is, okay, 100 kilometers. Let's take for example from Kalimpong, okay, from Kalimpong to Siliguri, it is 100 kilometers. This is the actual distance. This is the actual distance on the ground or actual distance of the earth. Okay. So, what will be the distance on the map? So, 1 centimeter is equal to 50 kilometers. So, how many centimeter is equal to 100 kilometers? So, which gives us the exact distance on the map? It gives us 2 centimeter. 2 centimeter is equal to 100 kilometers. So, the distance on the map. The distance on the map. So, the map distance is, the map distance is 2 centimeter, whereas the ground distance, G-R-O-U-N-D, ground distance is 100 kilometers. So, distance on the map is 2 centimeter, whereas distance on the ground is 100 kilometer. So, what it means? 2 centimeter on the map is equal to 100 kilometers on the ground. Remember that. You put it in your mind. 2 centimeter on the map is equal to 100 kilometers on the ground. In this way, we measure the distance from point A to B. Remember that. So they are basically, actually on the map, they are 2 centimeters apart. From A to B, they are basically 2 centimeters apart on the map. But in actual earth, there are 100 kilometers. So from Siliguri to Kalimpong, it is basically 100 kilometers apart. But if you basically find the distance of the map, it is basically 2 centimeters on the map, that is on the paper. This relation of 1 centimeter on the map representing 50 kilometers on the ground is the scale of the map. This is known as scale. This is known as scale. Remember that. Different maps have different scales. Okay? So what is a scale? Now remember this one. 2 centimeter on the map is equal to, okay, 100 kilometers on the ground. So distance on the map is equal to distance on the ground. Remember that. Now let's do some definition of the scale. What is a scale? A scale is a ratio. A scale is a ratio. Now, the ratio of the distance. Now, look at the definition carefully. Of the distance. Now, I am writing the distance in capital letters so that you can visualize what distance I am talking about. Distance between two points. Again, 2 points is coming here. Remember, 2 points. Which point I am talking about? This is distance between 2 points on the map. Map or paper. So, you can see here, okay, is the ratio. A scale is the ratio of the distance between 2 points on the map or paper. Okay? And the actual distance between
the same two points. Which two points I'm talking about? The same two points, that is A to B. Okay, same two points on the ground. G-R-O-U-N-D, ground. It is also called ground. It is also called actual distance. Okay, it is also called earth. Okay, remember that. So you can see here the difference. You can find, if you have understood this one, the previous, okay, working on the blackboard, you'll understand this definition very, very easily. So, and the actual distance is the earth distance between the same two points. Which two points? The two points which you have measured on the map, okay? In the map, you have measured from A to B, what is the distance? It is 2 centimeter. A to B is 2 centimeter, but in the, actually the distance is 100 kilometers on the ground. Now we are doing different types of scales. So I'm writing here, instead of different types of scales, I'm writing here, sewing the scale, because I have to sew the scale in order to make you understand what are the different types of scale. Therefore, I'm writing sewing the scale. There are three different ways, okay, of indicating or sewing the scale of a map. The three different ways are, number one, STATE, statement scale. Now I'm writing the word, okay? Statement scale, which is also known as a word scale, word scale or a verbal scale. VERBAL, verbal scale. It is also known as a verbal scale. Verbal scale, okay? It is also known as a verbal scale. The second scale is known as, or in your book it is written as graphical scale or linear scale, but actually I want to write you the correct name. That is known as GRADUATED, graduated straight line. STRAIGHT, straight line. If you find mistakes in my spellings, please, okay, rectify your, by yourself, okay? Straight line, okay, which is also known as graphical, GRAPHICAL, graphical scale, okay, which is also known as a bar scale, which is also known as a graphic scale, okay, or linear scale, LINEAR, linear, okay, NEAR, okay, linear scale. So this is known as linear scale, okay, LINEAR, okay. So I'm rubbing it once more so that you understand. LINEAR, linear scale, okay? It is also known as a linear scale. The last one is known as representative fraction, which is known as a numerical fraction, which is shown by a ratio or a fraction. Now, what is a ratio? You know, I think so. We are doing in maths, I think so. And what is a fraction? I think so. You know, in what is a fraction? So, 2:3 is ratio, okay? 2/3 is fraction. So this is a numerical fraction scale. This is a numerical fraction scale. It is also known as representative fraction. It is also known as representative fraction. F-R-A-C-T-I-O-N, fraction, which is known as RF. Okay. Now we are going to the first scale. We are going to study the first scale, which is known as a statement scale. This one? Okay. So, with this, okay, I have completed some of the topics which I have discussed today. Hope you find this lesson useful. In the next class, I will start with the statement scale. Thank you for listening.